Hi, welcome to this very brief lecture on the chromatography simulator, which I'll be providing for extra credit in week 6. Rather than give you all of the answers, I just wanted to introduce you to basically the Excel sheet that you can work with to get some idea about chromatography and how the parameters might affect your separation. This is a really fabulous simulation, so what I'm going to do is take you through the variables and explain their definitions in case you're confused, and then we'll go to the worksheet where we can change things around. Okay, so here we're dealing with a liquid chromatogram, and in this original system worksheet, none of these cells are changeable, but they tell you a lot about the system. For example, we have a packed bed column, we know the sphere size, we know the total pressure drop, the temperature, D sub M is the diffusion in the mobile phase. Sigma relates to, as you can see, basically how retained things are. So if you hover over these little red marks, you can get a definition of each of these things. So the extra column parameters, we haven't talked about these, but one of the things that affects term A in the Van Dinkter are kind of what happens to the stuff before it gets to the column. So that's what that deals with. Anyhow, these are parameters of the column. And then you see in the yellow the chromatogram, and below are things like the maximum capacity factor, which must be this peak way out here minus the retained T sub M divided by T sub M. The pressure of the column is also calculated. Remember, you need to keep that below about 1,000 bar, ideally 400 bar for a typical system. The flow rate, the number of plates, the retention time, I think, of the max peak, and then the resolution 1, 2, and 3, and it tells you of the first critical pair, second, and third. So you can get a lot of information by reading this, but realize this is kind of your comparison. So the best you could do in this system, and knowing the column length, which in this case is 250 millimeters, you can actually calculate the plate height pretty easily. I'm not going to do that for you, but you can actually calculate the plate height of this chromatogram. Now, what you're going to be doing on the extra credit is going to a system where you can actually play with the parameters. So the original chromatogram is shown here. So you've got 5 things you can play with, and in your extra credit, you're going to go through each one. First thing is actually the type of column. HC is something called a halo column, and I'll pull up Google real quick. This is actually what a halo column looks like. It's one of those porous layers surrounding a solid core. Anyhow, then you have a monolith, which I talked about in one of my liquid chromatography lectures, and then you have a conventional packed bed column, which are just packed beads. Now, what you can do in this, if you hit escape, that will go away, is you can do things like change the bead sides. So I'm going to make a prediction. If I make that bead size larger, I go to 5 microns, first of all, the column pressure should drop, and I should get a worse resolution, or my plate height should increase. So let's see what happens if I go to 5 microns. Sure enough, the pressure in the column drops. Remember that equation we learned, the pressure is proportional to the size, 1/1 the size of the spheres. The other thing you'll notice is that H from 5 microns to 19.2, which is a really big shift. The temperature is a bit high. Now I'm going to go down to a temperature of 30 C. And by the way, I don't want you to mess with delta P total. Just leave that alone. Anyhow, 30 C is a much more conventional temperature range. And I'm going to predict, remember, temperature is tricky depending if it's mass transport limited or if it's mobile phase limited. It's going to help one and it's going to hurt mobile phase. Given how fast our flow rates are here, I'm pretty sure we're mass transport limited. So I predict that this is going to make our plate height worse. Sure enough, it does. But 30 C is really practical. You really can't range a chromatography column more than about 70 or 80 C. And then finally, the length of the column. Let's go to 600. I know that's going to linearly increase my pressure, and it didn't do a lot to my plate height. So in any case, it gives you a sense of how you can play with all of these variables. And in your extra credit, you're going to be going through, and I'm going to be asking you to compare 2 different conditions and then tell me what you observed. And then you'll have some short answer capabilities, not all that carefully graded, I'm afraid. But at least it'll hopefully walk you through seeing how decisions you make about the column impact the chromatogram. Thanks so much. See you next time.